EThekwini Mayor Mxolisi Kaunda will engage residents of an informal settlement in Reservoir Hills regarding service delivery challenges in the area. This follows a public service delivery protest earlier this week. Issues were raised by the residents. It also includes poor maintenance of public ablution facilities and the installation of electricity in houses affected by fire. For more, our reporter Mlondi Radebe sent this report.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Durban. We are in Reservoir Hills, where the protest on Monday was very violent as cars were stoned and the M19 was closed between N2 and M19. The corner of M19 was closed by the protesters who were demanding electricity and water in this informal settlement. But next to me is the mayor of EThekwini, Ubaba Mxolisi Kaunda, who will briefly tell us about the current situation because he visited this area to try and resolve the matter. Babu Kaunda, thank you very much for your time. Briefly about the meeting you have with the community.
On Monday, I received a call around 5:30 in the morning that there was a road blockade in M19. Then after that, I had to make some calls to find out what are the challenges. I was informed that the community is angry because there was a commitment to reinstall their electricity after their houses were burned. And those were the issues which I was informed over the phone. I then took a decision to come and drive to this area in Mkotulu so that I can be able to interact with the community members. Indeed, we met with them and I committed that on Sunday today, I'll come back here to deliver a report on the issues which they raised with me. The first issue was about electricity. The second issue was about public ablution facilities. So we are happy to report today that since we met with the community, we sent our teams, they came here and people have been registered in terms of applying for the electricity. And we took a resolution in the council that we'll install those electricity gadgets for free to the community because it's part of the disaster that we have experienced in the area. But secondly, they also visited ablution facilities. They identify maintenance issues and those issues will be dealt with. I introduce the team that will be working on that particular project as from tomorrow. So the electricity will be installed as from tomorrow on Monday and as well as the maintenance of our ablution facilities. But we have also cautioned our administration that we need to act and act swiftly whenever community members they are raising the challenges they are confronted with.
But Mayor, will the community or must the community always protest before the mayor comes and or before they get services?
Yeah, the challenge was on the policy because we had to adopt a policy which was then presented on Tuesday in the executive and on Thursday it was passed by the council because the policy will enable the department to come swiftly, immediate the disasters have happened so that we do not wait for other processes and we just come in and zoom in the area and install and reinstall electricity. So this is the kind of the behavior that we are looking for from our side of our own officials in the council to ascertain that whenever people raise challenges, we respond with immediate effect.
But Mayor, there are issues about water leakages around the city, not here only. And do we have enough manpower to deal with those or do we have a capacity to deal with those?
Yes, we do have the capacity as a municipality, but we also extend this to service providers because if you look at the magnitude of the challenge that we are faced with here, it also requires more hands so that we are able to close all the leaks that are around the city. And we have also introduced a program, an operation called Operation Good Hope. That operation is zooming in to all areas, not only to look at the cleanliness, at the water leaks and sewer spillages, but they also attend to the potholes that are there in communities, overgrown veggies, so that we are able to maintain what we are supposed to be doing as a municipality. So therefore, we urge communities to work with us to ascertain that whatever challenges that they are confronted with, they must communicate with us wherever there is a challenge so that we can be able to respond.
How is the municipality dealing with the aging infrastructure?
The aging infrastructure, if you look at the budget we presented on Thursday, it is zooming in to ensure that we inject necessary resources so that we deal with the aging infrastructure. Durban Municipality Water. If you can drive around the CPD, you can see the work that we are doing just to renew and upgrade our pipes. If you go to communities in rural areas where we had challenges of adequate water supply, you can also observe the kind of work we are doing, because we are injecting more money to deal with our infrastructure, upgrade it, ensure that we also upgrade and expand our reservoirs so that they'll be able to supply adequate water to our communities.
Thank you very much, sir, for your time.
Thank you.
There was the mayor of the EThekwini, Baba Mxolisi Kaunda, briefing us about the issue that relates to aging infrastructure, also the protests that are mushrooming around the city in relation to service delivery. Back to you in studio.